Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can create the mullions in Dynamo and import them into Revit. You notice that we already have the curtain walls and everything. I want to get the boundaries of the curtain walls so I can create mullions in the boundaries. So let's go back here. Now, if I want to select all the curtain panels which are available in my Revit file, I can go to Revit, selection. And I want to go with all elements of family type. I want to bring also family types. I can assign this to that. And if I go with system panel glazed, it's going to select all the curtain panels that we have, which in this case there are 392. Okay, so all of them are now selected. Next, I would like to get the boundaries of these elements so I know where to create the mullions. Because this is an element, if I go to Revit Elements, if I go to Curtain Panels, here I can get the boundaries. How do I know a curtain panel is an element? Because it's under the Elements menu under Revit. If I assign this to that, go with Run, it's going to create all the boundaries here in Dynamo as well, right? So now if I create any geometry in Dynamo, I can assign them to the exact location of the curtain panels. Okay, and you see the output is poly curves, so I have curves here. Now I want to show you something else. Because this is a curve type, if I go to the curve menu, there is an interesting item here which will allow me to get the start point of the curve. So I want to go with this one. I want to assign poly curve to curve. Now, if I run this, you're going to see that it created points at the start point of each of the curves. So if I create a mullion, it's going to assign it to that point. Okay, now I'm going to show you two different methods of how we can create the mullions. The first method is using cuboids. So there is an option to create cuboids based on one set of points. How about so far I create a group here. This group is responsible to create boundaries and start points of curtain panels that we have in Revit in Dynamo. Okay. How about I change this to a whole different color? There we go. So I want to assign the points to points. That means I want to have a set of cuboids starting from each of those points. If I run this, you're going to see that a cube, which is 1 meter by 1 meter by 1 meter, is created in each of those items. Now, what do I need to do next? I need to assign width, length and height. So let's say, for instance, if I want to go with 10 by 10 centimeters objects, I can assign this to that, and you see that some objects are created over there. Now the height is actually the same height that we have for the curtain panels. So I can do this. I can get parameter value by name. I can assign elements to elements, and I can get the height using one string, type height, assign height to parameter name. If I run this, you see that the height is 3.4, which we already had. I can assign this to my height, and let's see what happens. I'm gonna organize here a little bit over there. I'm gonna move them over there. Let's run this. Okay, there we go. Now some cuboids are created. They are 3.4 meters in height, which is correct. However, the origin point is at the middle, so I need to move them by half that 3.4 up, so they're gonna be in the exact location. How about I group these as cuboids? These are basically my mullions created in Dynamo. So cuboids for the mullions or for the curtain panels. Okay, this is good. I'm gonna change the color. Now, next thing I wanna do, I want to move these cuboids up by half of that height. So I'm gonna go with move, which is the same as translate in Dynamo. That can go there. This is gonna be assigned to that. And that height should be divided by 2 because we're gonna move it by half of the height, and then we're gonna assign it to my Z translation. And it's important that we turn this off. So now you see that we have the mullions, which are 0.1 by 0.1. I can go, for instance, by 20 by 20 centimeters, and they're gonna be a little bit bigger. I'm gonna group all these items together as cuboids. There we go. Okay, so now you see these objects. All the mullions are created. You can work with different geometries, and by the end, whenever you are happy with the outcome, you can do this. Let's see, we have 392 items in a list here. Let's see what happens if I go with import by geometries. So I'm gonna go with import by geometries, because when you go to Revit, you see that there is a box here, but you cannot select it or anything here in Revit. That cuboid cannot be selected here because it's not an object yet in Revit. In order for that to become an object, you need to export it into Revit. So import by geometries, I'm gonna assign this to that, run. I'm gonna go to Revit. Now those objects are actually created, and I can select them one by one. Okay, now how can I assign materials and everything to those objects? You need to go to manage object styles. The last menu is imported objects, and you see there are a lot of them, and each of these items you click on, actually the material is assigned from here. That means if you want to assign material, you need to open one by one so you can select the layer inside to assign material. Well, this is not very efficient, right? So I'm gonna do something else. I want to flatten the list first. So you see this is a list within a list. I want to flatten that list. That goes there. I want to run this. Now there are only one list. I want to assign this to that, run, and we're going to see this time how they are imported into Revit. Let's go to Revit. Okay, let me go to object styles. We can see it from there. Import objects, there we go. Now all of them are in one single layer. I can click on that layer, and because they are only in one layer, it's very easy to assign some kind of material. Okay, let's change this to like shaded, and now you see that we have all those mullions here. Okay, so this is one way of creating mullions. You can define different materials or something, and because I flattened them, you notice that they're imported as one single layer.